quote the appropriately topical Alanis Morissette, I'm broke, but I'm happy. Ladies, you are looking at the lap of luxury. Follow me, if you will, taking a peek around my room. Yeah, it's pretty magical here. My room, which just so happens to reside inside of my parents' house. My roomies, you know, buddies. Broke, 24, dinosaur lover. How did I get to this state? It's an interesting question. Multiple choice time, my friends. Why, pray tell, did Ashley quit her job and wind up alone in her parents' house? Is it A, because she is not a fan of the recession, and she just decided that it would be a great time to quit her job, be moneyless? That sounds like a great thing to do in an already struggling economy. Jobs will be easy to find. Or is it B, she hates corporations and they are taking over the world? They're also leading to the ultimate destruction and dark force in alien invasion. I'm sorry, there's a lot of things that are involved with B, so just know that you're jumping into a melting pot with that one. Or is it C, the less exciting, quit her job in pursuit of her dreams? Because those always come true and everybody tells you to really put stock in them. Yeah, I decided to make my parents the proudest they've ever been, and I quit my job that they were already really proud of and decided to completely throw it all away because I wanted to follow my dreams of being a stand-up comedian. Brilliant. I know. It was, I consider, a lateral move. Not even mentally. I'm completely jobless right now, but I am happier than I have ever been. And I'm sure it is absolutely easy to just sit down and go, oh, well, of course you're happy, you quit your job, you have nothing to do, you're doing whatever you want all the time. Not really whatever I want, but also whatever I want. And whatever I want just so happens to be taking a spiritual journey within myself. And I know that a lot of people are gonna go, golly days, look at this hippy dippy nut. This one being all cuckoo bananas with the hippies and the crystals and the space and everything. Whatever, guys, it's all connected. Everybody thinks that I'm so weird because I like dinosaurs, but they're part of a bigger story. They're part of the story of evolution. You think about how long dinosaurs were on this earth for, and in case you didn't know, got the fact up there, my friend. Check it out for yourself. As you can see, dinosaurs, they far outlived us, and their evolutionary pattern or whatever you want to call it, over the course of the millennia, over the course of the millions of years that they existed, they developed from these small little things to these highly developed, large, vast creatures. That's incredible. And then I look at humans, and here we are, just a little blip on the radar as far as time is concerned. But when it comes to evolution, yes, we've gone from a hunched state, really sexy, we've gone from that up to where we are today as far as physical transformations. But I don't think it's so crazy to think that the next change, the next move in evolutionary existence for humans could be a mental one. I don't think I'm crazy for drawing parallels between the conversations I'm having with my friends and what's going on in my own head. I felt like I was going on this crazy journey all by myself where I felt super idealistic, more idealistic than I already had, and I was pretty fucking idealistic all my life. But I felt this sense of connectivity with whoever or whatever it is that exists within me that makes me me. I consider it a soul. Some people just consider it a light, an energy, an existence, a persona, what have you. That. I was tapping into that. That was starting to to bubble up within me, and all I wanted to do was answer this call, and all I had was more and more questions about everything from just education on things that have happened here on Earth. How did we get here? How did the Earth evolve? How did we as a people and a society and just humanity, but not humanity just limited to humans. I mean, all things with light and energy inside of them. Just how we've evolved, how the Earth came to be, how that prior, like what happened with the Big Bang, did it happen? You know, what happened prior to that point in time? What about black holes? Like all of these questions just, I had such a thirst for everything that existed around me. I just wanted to know about it. And for the first time ever, for the first time in history, other people are feeling that too. And we have a place that we can go. And if you know what you're doing, if you give the old Google Scholar a try versus just the old regular Google, you'll find that if you keep your eyes open, you can find all the information that you want. It's at our fingertips. It really is an amazing thing, the internet. But it also takes us on this really awful, negative, dare I say evil journey sometimes, where I've found myself on sites that I consider enlightening or maybe just socially fixated. Every once in a while I've caught myself on websites that I have no business being on or that I don't even want to be on for hours at a time. And why? There's something keeping us there. There's something either on the subconscious or completely surface. I mean, there is nothing to it. It's just sheer boredom. There you are. But what if we all filled that time, even if it is still on the internet, with answering questions and filling a thirst for knowledge and following our dreams and figuring out what it is within us that makes us happy and makes us feel like we can connect with other people and enrich their lives while enriching our own? I don't know. Maybe I am a wacky hippie. I mean, I did. Look at this bad guy. Cut the sleeves off of it. Like a boss. Like a boss, you know. Also have my clothes color coordinated and done in short sleeve, sleeveless to long sleeve. Like a boss. Yeah, it just, I don't know how it stops. This is why I don't vlog. Have a lovely day. So long, motherfuckers!
Right on the tip.